And I want to give you just a quick exhortation about prayer and how significant and how important it is for you and for me. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, Jesus said, "This then, pray then like this." He said, this is how you should pray. And he said, it starts with the acknowledgement of our Father. And that is a way of signaling you to acknowledge the presence of God. How can you pray if you don't even acknowledge someone's presence? And so that's what you do when you're praying. Really, it's kind of like breathing. You're inhaling because you're acknowledging someone's presence. Now, it says in heaven. The idea behind this is that you're declaring the preeminence or the prominence of God, that God is not just your Father. He's the King of all kings and the ruler of the universe and the creator of all things, and He has dominion over all things. He's prominent. He's not just anybody. That's why we hallow His name, or we praise His name. Hallowed be Thy name. We're acknowledging Your presence, we're acknowledging Your prominence, and as a result of that, we praise You. But more than that, Your kingdom come, He says. Your kingdom come is really acknowledging not just His preeminence, His presence, but His power. That God deserves praise and worship and is worthy of our time and acknowledgement, not just on a Sunday or on a broadcast like this, but literally every day of the week, because He's powerful. And thus, Your will be done. Because of who You are, because You're the King of kings, because You're the Lord of lords, then we acknowledge not just Your power, we acknowledge Your purposes over our lives. We want Your priorities, not ours. And on earth as it is in heaven means in this present time, we believe that. And so as we begin to worship, I want to let you just understand how this works. Prayer is not about the what, it's not the when, it's not the who, it's not the where. It's about the, it's not the when and the how, but the who. It's His presence, the presence of this person, the prominence of this person, the power of this person, and more importantly, the purpose of this person. And prayer is God's presence, acknowledging that presence, and not just when you're here at a service like this, but literally every day of your life. And to acknowledge that He's not just present, but that He's prominent and that He's preeminent over every situation of our lives and that He has the power. And as such, we decide that we want His purpose. So, Father, we acknowledge Your presence as we end this moment of prayer. And, Father, we pray for the nation of China. We pray that very same prayer, Lord. We pray for Your presence upon that nation. Help that government to know, Lord, Your preeminence, Your prominence, that You have power to save, and that Your purposes will prevail, and that someday, God, that nation will learn to praise You. And Father, we pray, Father, for the workers of Singapore and the healthcare workers. We entrust them to Your grace. We pray, Father, that the scourge of this virus will be contained, Lord. And Father, help Your people to learn in this junction of our history to know how to take care of our own health, that, Lord, it's not to be taken for granted. Give us wisdom, God, in Jesus' name. Amen.